Senator, let's bring in Texas Senator John Cornyn now. As we detailed, he was down there. It was a bipartisan congressional delegation, him and Henry Cuellar, fellow Texas member of Congress. He's a congressman as opposed to being in the Senate. But that the interesting thing was that the two of you were down there taking a look at it, Senator. And when you hear Alejandro Mayorkas saying that this is the worst border challenge, as he put it, in 20 years, what's your reaction?
Well, my reaction is, why did the Biden administration make this worse? By revoking the migrant protection program, by not enforcing the public health order, Title 42, by coming up with no solution to the catch and release system that we know encourages illegal migration, they simply are making things worse. And my hope is that the president will come to the border. I would be glad to host him along with the Texas delegation to show him what we see and to talk to the experts that I talk to when I go to the border, which are largely the Border Patrol, Health and Human Services, and the Office of Refugee Relocation.
Senator, is that realistic to think that President Biden may pay a visit to the border? He was just asked about that, as you probably just heard a moment ago, as he was departing the White House. No plans, he said, to do that.
Well, I understand he may not have any current plans, but I would encourage him to do so. He was good enough to come visit Texas a couple of weeks ago, as you'll recall, after our polar vortex, our incredible weather event we had. This, I think, is going to get worse. Director Mayorkas is correct, but all they want to do is to blame it on the Trump administration when, in fact, they've dismantled those policies and made them worse.
Senator, stay with us because we're going to keep you around for an extended period of time, but what we want right now just to interject another aspect of this. The border crisis is starting to have some real political implications. Kristen Fisher is live at the White House with that. Hi, Kristen.
Hey, John. Well, top administration officials are starting to use words that sure sound a lot like crisis to describe the situation at the border. You've got White House Press Secretary Jen Psaki calling it a big problem. And then you've got the Department of Homeland Security Secretary Alejandro Mayorkas describing it as difficult. And just look at how serious this surge is expected to be, according to the words of the DHS secretary. He put out a statement just this morning that said, quote, "We are on pace to encounter more individuals on the southwest border than we have in the last 20 years. Why? Well, in that statement, Secretary Mayorkas never blames the current administration's policies. Instead, he blames it on hurricanes, the pandemic, problems in Central American countries, and on the Trump administration.
Do not come now. Give us the time to rebuild the system that was entirely dismantled in the prior administration. And we have, in fact, begun to rebuild that system.
So the secretary is continuing to tell migrants, do not come now, not do not come, period. Even as the administration is bringing in FEMA to help and opening up the Dallas Convention Center for thousands of migrant teenagers. And one of the biggest questions continues to be, when will the administration allow reporters and cameras inside some of these facilities to see what kinds of conditions these children are being kept in firsthand? John, as you know, this is something that the Trump administration repeatedly got hammered on. John?
Yep. Kristen Fisher for us across the street at the White House. Kristen, thanks so much. Let's go back to Texas Senator John Cornyn. Speak to this idea, if you could, Senator, of the blame game that's going on. Clearly, the Trump administration had a hardline immigration policy, but Roberta Jacobson, the commissioner for the border, the ambassador, suggested that it was the promise of new Biden administration policies that led to a feeling of hope that created the surge.
Well, whatever happened to enforcing the law? The Biden administration seems to have no interest in enforcing the law, and all the signals they're sending is if you can make it to our borders, you're going to be able to successfully migrate into the United States, regardless of what the law says. But we know intermixed among these unaccompanied children are sex offenders, criminal aliens, people committed very serious crimes. And of course, the cartels, the smugglers who get paid $5,000, $6,000, $7,000 a person to smuggle people in the United States, they have a business model and an incentive to place as many people in the United States as they can. In the meantime, I've heard zero from the administration about what they are planning to do to eliminate catch and release, other than to build more holding facilities in places like Midland and Dallas. But the Border Patrol tells me you can't build enough facilities to deal with this. You have to deal with what they call the pull factors, which are the impression that if you make it to the border, you're going to be able to get into the United States.
Seems to be growing pressure on the administration to answer those questions. Kevin McCarthy led a delegation to the border yesterday. He stepped in front of a microphone, talked about what he saw. Here was part of his message, Senator.
I know the president's going to travel this week. This is where he should bring Air Force One. This is where he should look the people in the eye. This is where he should talk to the border agents and let them know that this is beyond a crisis. He can continue to deny it, but the only way to solve it is to first admit what he has done. And if he will not reverse action, it's going to take congressional action to do it.
Senator, John Katko was also standing there. He stepped up to the microphone as well, and he said, quote, individuals that they have on the watch list for terrorism are now starting to exploit the southern border. What more can you tell us about that, speaking directly on your state?
Well, when we were in Carrizo Springs, so we talked to the Border Patrol, who controls the Del Rio sector there. And they said just in the last couple of months, they had detained people from 54 different countries. This isn't just a phenomenon from people coming from Mexico or Central America. This is literally people who, if you pay enough money to the smugglers, you can make your way into the United States. And these same smuggling corridors are used to smuggle people, to traffic in girls and women, is used for drugs. And 92% of the heroin in the United States comes from Mexico. Last year, we lost 80,000 people to drug overdoses. That's one of the contributing causes.
Senator, are you hearing anything in your position on the Intelligence Committee about a potential threat to America coming through the southern border?
Well, the truth is we don't know what we don't know, John. Nothing specific, but we do know that it's a vulnerability. And indeed, we've seen people on countries of special interest, for example, that make their way into the United States. We don't know who they are, really where they come from, what their background is. And I think that's potentially a dangerous situation.
Senator, also the Arizona AG joined us last hour. Some really powerful words at the top of the hour on the elimination of the public charge rule, what the Biden administration is doing with this, and the economic impact, Senator. Real quick, here's the AG.
By eliminating the public charge rule, the Biden administration is essentially giving our hard-earned tax dollars, anyone that pays federal or state tax dollars, to people that are not here legally. So whether that's free health care, free education, it's creating an incentive, and we're seeing the consequences of these two Biden policies. They've incentivized crossing the border illegally with no consequences.
Can you speak directly to that in your state, Texas?
He's entirely correct. This is one of those pull factors, in addition to catch and release, which send the message that there will be no consequences associated with your entering the United States illegally. In fact, you'll have a benefit conferred upon you thanks to the hardworking American taxpayer. Even though you've dishonored our laws and jumped in line ahead of the hundreds of thousands of people who do it the right way through legal immigration.
Senator, with regard to the health aspect of all of this, and I think that this is a really important point because here in the United States, we've dealt with coronavirus lockdowns, we've dealt with restaurants that are going under because people can't come in and eat because of COVID restrictions. People are wearing masks everywhere, well, except Texas and a couple of other places now by mandate. And our Griff Jenkins has got some great sources in Customs and Border Protection. More than 220 individuals have come across at Brownsville, tested positive for COVID, and then were released into the United States. What is the health, the public health danger in these border crossings?
Well, unfortunately, we don't know how many people have made it into the United States who've not been tested at all. But you're entirely correct that we have people who have been tested. They don't have facilities to detain them and keep them in quarantine, so they're merely asked to, once you get to your final destination, please self-quarantine. And you can imagine what the results are there. So this is, I think, highly dangerous, particularly
in the wake of this pandemic we've been living with for the last year. Title 42, issued by the Center for Disease Control, was supposed to protect us from non-essential travel back and forth across the border as a public health measure. The Biden administration is ignoring it or cherry-picking it and allowing people who should not be able to cross the border, certainly people with positive COVID-19 tests, to enter the interior. And I think that, again, it's a public health danger.
Senator John Cornyn, really appreciate your time this afternoon. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, Senator. We'll see you again soon. We'll check back in with you after your trip to the border this Friday. Thank you.
Absolutely.